understanding where and when thunderstorms form is important for the general public. When they become severe, we need to know where they're going to form. We need to eventually understand something more about why they become severe, but the first step is understanding why and when they form. In general, my research involves the use of unmanned aircraft to understand thunderstorms. We use two types of drones for our research. A fixed-wing drone that looks like a regular aircraft, except much smaller and of course with no person on it, and rotary wing or multi-rotor aircraft. These are the drones with multiple helicopter-like rotors on it that go up and down. The drones are outfitted with fairly simple instruments. There's a pressure, temperature, moisture sensor on it. There's also a wind sensor, so we measure the wind velocity in three dimensions. So not only the horizontal wind, but also the vertical updrafts and downdrafts that the aircraft might encounter. The ground-based vehicles that we use as part of the unmanned aircraft system are what we call mobile mesonets. The reason it complements unmanned aircraft is because ideally what you want to get is a stacked tower. You want to get observations near the ground as well as above the ground. This July we'll be conducting a field experiment in southern Colorado in the San Luis Valley. It's a great laboratory for examining a variety of phenomena, but one of the things that we're focusing on is thunderstorm initiation. It's an EPSCoR project at NSF, so it involves Oklahoma State University, University of Kentucky, University of Oklahoma, and of course, University of Nebraska. University of Nebraska, we have multiple investigators involved, and they all revolve around this core objective, which is to bring atmospheric science and unmanned aircraft together to advance understanding, but and in the end, advance predictability. So the plan is to go out with 30 unmanned aircraft and sample the heck out of it, and hopefully in the process, if we've designed the experiment correctly, get some data that we can use to understand how the atmosphere interacts with the land to support the formation of thunderstorms.